Okay. Welcome to Ernie Kovacs' Cavalcade of Fun.
Revisited.
I can't hear Paula.
I can hear me now.
So tonight on the show, our saving the day is our guest, Bed Ronald.
Here he comes to save the day.
Ron, it's good having you on the show. What have you been up to lately? You got any things going on? I know your parents are celebrating their 75th anniversary, which is really something. How they managed to do that, I'll never know. 75 years. Now, what's that like for them? Have they been happily married for 75 years? Or have there been trials? Is that yes or no? Yes? Is it yes? I'm taking that probably as a yes. There's probably been some ups and downs. Have there been ups and downs over the years? Trials and tribulations? Dogs and cats? Daughters and sons? Nephews and nieces?
What's that? Is that the sexual thing you're doing?
Oh, that many nephews and nieces? Jeez. All right. So anyways, tonight on the show, our friend Jim McLaughlin, how do you describe Jim McLaughlin, Paula?
He is a...
Is he a nerd?
No.
Is he a wimp?
No, he's not a nerd or a wimp. He's a freak.
Oh, freak. I'm sorry. Get those confused. So our friend Jim McLaughlin, Bad Ronald. Well, not our friend Jim McLaughlin, Bad Ronald, but our friend Bad Ronald, Jim McLaughlin.
No, comma.
Not Bad Ronald. No, I'm talking about our friend Jim McLaughlin. He's a nerd or a freak or a zoob? Is he a zoob? Anyways.
I think he's a cartoon character.
Jim went to, and Ron's Not?
No. Jim's a superhero.
We could do one of our songs, I guess. Anyways. Jim went to Philadelphia recently, and he interviewed people, as he's wont to do. And we're going to look at some of Jim McLaughlin in Philadelphia now.
As Elton John sang a song called Philadelphia Freedom, this song was about A, eating as many Philly cheesesteaks as you want, B, winning a Super Bowl without Donovan McNabb as your QB, or C, taking Lindsay Lohan's ankle monitor off so she can drive you to drink.
D, not, none of the above.
Thank you very much, Chris.
All right, so I want to thank Davey Anderson for the opening music on the show tonight.
It was so nice of him.
You're watching Ernie Kovacs' Cavalcade of Fun here on Cable Access in Buffalo, New York. Bad Ronald is here and Paula is here.
Weep, weep, weep.
And Jim McLaughlin will be in Philadelphia all night with updates on Philadelphia. Via satellite. He's in Philadelphia via satellite.
Jim McLaughlin via satellite.
Hold on, I'm getting something. Wait. Hold on. All right, hold on. I think a message is coming in. It's hard to decode, though. Do you hear that, Paula? It's like the aliens are invading.
I think
I have a feeling we leave the house. All the other houses will be burned to cinders.
There's probably a code. I can't make it out, though.
All right, I'm not really into corniness. Okay, anyways, what was I guess? Oh, yeah, so Michael Vick has been killing dogs, and I think that's good. Because we all, I mean, America.
Who's Michael Vick?
I've been watching a lot of these shows where the hosts are eating a hamburger. And they're saying, I'm so outraged that Michael Vick is killing dogs. I mean, we're slaughtering pigs, cows, chicken, turkey. We're fishing. And then we're worried about killing dogs. I say, go for killing dogs. What's the big deal about killing dogs? You agree with me, right, Paula?
Well, not if it's your pet.
Drown a dog, electrocute a dog, stop a dog to death. Big deal. Why is that illegal? And why is it immoral?
During the Lewis and Clark thing, they were eating dogs on the trail.
The Lewis and Clark thing. Can you specify what that is?
The Lewis and Clark expedition.
Oh, the Lewis and Clark expedition,
they
of course.
They were eating dogs on the trail.
So they would be in favor of Michael Vick murdering dogs, though.
Well, they also had a mascot who was a dog, and they didn't eat him.
And hot dogs,
they're not made of dogs.
Of course they are. They're cooked dogs.
They're not made of dogs.
You think
everything but dogs.
Do you think when you get a chicken sandwich, is it made of chicken?
They're squirrels. They're made of squirrels.
Anyways, so Michael Vick is doing the Ron, you agree with that's a good thing, right? You get a dog, you want it to kill the other dog. It won't fight to the death. It pussies out. You drown it. You electrocute it. I mean, isn't that the reasonable thing to do? I think it is.
No, you're wrong.
Oh, my God, he speaks.
Harpo speaks. Okay, anyways, Jim McLaughlin is via satellite now out in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Jim,
let's go to Jim McLaughlin in
Jim?
Pennsylvania.
Come in, Jim.
The Philadelphia story tells about A, Rocky Balboa taking many punishing blows and coming back from brain surgery to beat the heck out of his opponent. B, Nicolas Cage finding our national treasure without holding down a regular job. Or C, gay people getting the short end of the stick. What do you think is the correct answer to this question?
I have to say I have no background to any of these answers, but I would go for B.
I thank you very much.
Well, anyways, all right, so Jim McLaughlin, actually the answer, Jim, if you can hear me via satellite, if you're still there, it's The Philadelphia Story. That's a movie starring Katharine Hepburn and Cary Grant and Jimmy Stewart. It has nothing to do with Philadelphia, the movie. That's called Philadelphia. It has nothing to do with Rocky Balboa that takes place in Philadelphia. And it has nothing to do with Nicolas Cage, which has nothing to do with Philadelphia whatsoever. Even though the guy said B, Nicolas Cage. I don't know. All right. So we're back with Bad Ronald, who's very, very bad.
He's very bad.
And
it sounds like a siren in some crazy, weird planet. Pull the car over, dear. There's an ambulance behind us.
Every week, bad television, guaranteed.
Bad television at its
for
finest.
For you. If you're looking for bad television, bad Ronald television every week, it's,
look, here we are.
Look no further.
Here we are.
Hello, Cleveland.
It's nice. Drew Carey is going to be the host of The Price is Right.
I wanted that job. I did.
You just like the.
You're so good
you like
at
the,
it too.
You like the models that pointed out the stuff. Didn't
would you,
you?
If you were the host of The Price is Right, would you sexually harass the models?
No.
Would you?
He did
fuck
though.
Them.
You know he did that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
No. If
you wouldn't even
if fuck
they
them to go out for a drink afterwards.
Don't fuck.
Even
if they wanted, even if they wanted to be sexually harassed.
Oh, you would. Oh, if they wanted to drink with you and then fuck, you just said. That what you said the right way.
He's got to wait a minute. They got to buy
I
him
said,
a drink
you,
first.
You, oh yeah, I know that's the right way. Drink and fuck.
Yeah. Yes.
Would you fuck? No, I wouldn't do that. But if you do it the right way, drinking and fucking, then I would do it. That's what you just said, Ron. Yeah, good answer, Ron. Mexico.
I can't answer that.
You just did.
You said the F-word.
We have it on tape.
My mom's going to watch this
oh
next
my
week.
God. Don't tell her about it.
After her 50th wedding.
She's going to watch it after her 75th anniversary. So on her 75th anniversary, she's going to be watching this show. Is that how she wants to celebrate?
50.
What did I say?
75.
You said F about four or five times.
I know.
I didn't say F. You
okay.
Say F.
I say F.
Go ahead, Ron.
Would I like to have a little, like...
Cleansing?
No, I'm thinking like a Bill Clinton thing
sexual
going on.
Sexual healing.
Yeah, like a Bill Clinton thing. Yeah.
Oh, with someone giving a blowjob under the desk?
Oh, my God. Of course.
Let me show you my panties.
At work?
That was never proven.
And yet. You want to have your semen on a dress? Is that what you're saying?
I'm talking about The Price is Right.
Oh, The Price is Right. But what does Bill Clinton have to do with that, though?
Never mind.
I didn't get that. Did you get that?
No, you did get it, kind of.
Oh.
Never mind.
That would have been a good choice for The Price is Right, though. Bill Clinton was a new...
Oh, my God. I know.
Can you
he'd have all
it?
Girls. Come on down, girls.
And I mean that sincerely.
What's going to happen with
down.
Drew Carey's new show that they've been like hyping the heck out of for the last month?
Yeah, and now he's got two shows. This guy's a genius.
Unbelievable.
Cleveland
really?
Rocks. You know, and he doesn't even have... He got laser surgery, yet he still wears the glasses everywhere. They're his trademark. He doesn't need them anymore.
Well, you know, he tried. For a while, he didn't wear the glasses.
But now he's back to them because no one recognizes
him. The ladies didn't like him.
Yeah, no one knows who he is without the glasses. So even though he has laser surgery, he has 20/20 vision now, he wears glasses. What a phony. Anyways. All right, so anyways.
He's from Cleveland, though. I mean, it's down home... You know, America.
That's even worse
like
because
Buffalo.
He's down home America and he's being a phony wearing glasses when he doesn't even need them. That's like walking around with a crutch when you're fine.
People wear glasses.
Yeah, but
people wear glasses all the time that don't need them.
Yeah, those phonies in Hollywood.
I, fashion glasses.
Lisa Loeb, look at those.
You wouldn't catch me wearing glasses if I didn't need them.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I know, because the lights in here are definitely too bright
It's a TV studio, you know.
It is a TV studio. You're right.
Jim McLaughlin, our nerdy friend, he's in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania
he's
right now.
Not
That's
nerdy.
In the United States of America.
It is.
And we're going to go to him via satellite. Jim, are you there?
Drew, your question here today is, Bobby Clark, former general manager of the Flyers, was unsuccessful while guiding the Broad Street Bullies because, A, he couldn't communicate clearly because he lost too many teeth during his playing days, B, got bored with prospects at the NHL draft that nobody knows about, or C, just as Winona Ryder was not responsible for shoplifting in 2001 due to drugs, Bobby Clark did not know what he was doing because he was on drugs too. What's the correct answer there?
I'm going to go with B. It seems like the only reasonable answer.
Thank you very much, Drew. Appreciate it.
Thank you. All right, Jim. You're doing really well there, boy. Keep up the good work. So everything's going haywire. The NBA is totally fixed, we found out, which is good. Which is no surprise, because for years they've been saying things like, well, there's the Michael Jordan rules. You know, he gets to do whatever he wants. They never call the fouls they're supposed to. There's always some weird thing going on with the officials. So it's no surprise. Please enjoy yourself over there. Well, later on the show, Paul and I are going to start doing our duo. What are we calling it?
Oh, we don't have
Bro Cream.
Bro Cream.
Our new duo, Bro Cream. And we're doing Paula's song, You're a Fucking Asshole.
That's not it. It's actually called Booty Call.
But what's the lyric in it? It says you are a goddamn asshole.
I hate your guts. It's not an effing asshole.
So this is about a guy that was really good with you in bed, but you didn't like his personality, right? Who was this? Was this Gwen's father? Was this Gwen's father?
It might be.
So you wrote this song about Gwen Kears, our friend's father, Neil. About how he was good in bed, but he was just an empty shell.
Well,
he was not an asshole.
It was actually a compilation of men, but he was one of the compilation. Sure,
he was the king of the compilation, wasn't
king
he?
King compilation.
Let's start.
Well, I was going to do it with.
No, he's doing the drums on this.
No, but you can do a song with her. Go ahead.
No,
why don't we do two versions? You do the two versions right now, Ron. See which version's better. Go ahead. I'll do the version later.
We're not going to do the same song twice.
Yeah, because you know the song. You don't anyway. That would be unfair to me. I don't know how she wants it done.
Well, we can do a song right now. Why don't we do like one of those?
No, you got.
What song do we both?
Yeah, why don't you do a song with Greg?
What song do we both know?
I don't know.
Anyways, via satellite in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, is Jim McLaughlin.
Jim,
he's not a nerd.
Jim, can you hear me?
He's not a nerd.
Jim.
Your question, Meredith, is Danny Briere, former Buffalo Sabre, is now a member of the Philadelphia Flyers. Does Danny Briere, A, astonish you, B, mystify you, or C, love you?
I would say, since my husband is a huge Bills fan, he loves us.
Thank you very much. Football team recently lost their 10,000th.
Jim, I can hear you there for a second. Now I've lost you again. Anyways, Jim, tell Meredith that the hockey team in Buffalo, New York, is called the Sabres. Even though Brad Ronald is wearing a shirt here that's Buffalo Hockey Club, the Buffalo Bisons, it also says 1928 to 1970. So that was the old. She could have said Bisons or Sabres. I would have accepted either of those, but she said Bills. That is the professional football team. Meredith.
Football.
See, your husband's a big fan of the Buffalo Bills. They play football.
Football.
Danny Briere, he is a hockey player. Okay, just to clarify. That was really timely. He's in Philadelphia, and he's asking about Daniel Briere. This guy's a genius, Jim McLaughlin.
What a genius.
And Ben Round, you're a very good conversationalist, I must say. So anyways, we found out this week that the NBA is fixing all the games. No surprise there. I got a good idea for the movie. Rob Nesbitt's here, and we'll bring him on shortly. Anyways, Jim McLaughlin is hanging out in Philadelphia. Jim, come in.
Your question here is the Philadelphia Phillies baseball team recently lost their 10,000th game. This happened because A, the Phillies play with too much love and not enough hate. B, Pete Rose is not betting on the team anymore, or C, the Phillies don't have enough players on steroids?
They don't have enough players on steroids.
I thank you very much.
Okay, thanks, Jim, and I want to thank Bad Ronald for being on the show tonight.
It's lovely.
Once upon a time, you dressed so fine, threw the bumps of dime in your prime, did you? People call it the same farewell down. I'm kidding you. It was better when you were doing the other beat. Okay. Paul and I are going to do our song now about our friend Gwen Kearse's father, Neil. And... all right, we're gonna clip for that, and then I'll be doing the drum pad thing, and Paula will be singing. Okay, clip.
Oh, the phone rang. I looked at the clock. It was 2:15. I shook out the sleep from my head and knew it was you. You said that you had been a fool and you missed my green eyes. But I knew what you missed, cause it lives at the top of my thighs. Against my good judgment, I let you come over that night. We rocked and we rolled up until the dawn's early light. When it was morning, I came to and I kicked you out. And I do it again, cause you're someone I can't live without. All the sex in the world can't disguise the fact you're an asshole. That erection you're hiding behind is no more than a pole. You're soulless and spineless without any merit at all. But brother, you are good for something, you're some booty call. I used to love you and pray every day you'd love me. I'd cry when you leave and I never knew where you would be. I wasn't aware that you hadn't the depth of a teaspoon. And yours is the picture in Webster's next to the word goon. I thought you were wise with your brilliant brown eyes and your silence. Attributing thoughts that were deep and profound to your mind. It turns out the lights were not on and the darkness was so dense. I couldn't break through it with any sharp wit I could find. All the sex in the world can't disguise the fact you're an asshole. That erection you're hiding behind is no more than a pole. You're soulless and spineless without any merit at all. But baby, you are good for something, you're some booty call.
Said, all right, this week with Ken Vaughn, the snappiest dresser in America, if not the world, if not the universe,
he designs his
if
own
not
clothes.
The whole fucking galaxy.
Some of these clothes he's designed himself.
You didn't design any clothes.
She designed that orange jacket he had on.
She designed that orange
he
jacket?
He designed
it. You call him a she now?
I said,
Ken's
yeah.
A man.
Hey.
You said she. Roll the fucking tape back.
I said he.
What? Why are you calling Ken she?
He.
She designed
he.
I don't like you calling my male friend she, Paula. I take offense to that. Don't pull that bullshit here. That's not how we roll on this show with obnoxious crap.
Well, you know why? Because I think so highly of him that I was willing
oh, right. Because you like the broads. It's funny because he's a male showing his pig.
I know.
Now, what are you talking about?
You know you're a male showing his pig.
I am not.
You know you are.
No,
you know you are.
Male superiority, don't you?
What?
You believe in male superiority, don't you?
Of course he does.
What's that?
That's where wow. Men are superior to broads. You got to admit that's true. Come on. We all know it's true.
Well.
Not only is it true, but you also believe it.
Well.
Come on, you know it's true.
It's not true.
Well, let's look at the facts here, Paula. Women's personalities in general blow. Am I right?
That doesn't mean
they
not
suck
smart.
And blow. I didn't say
that's
I'm saying
one aspect.
They suck and blow?
They suck. Well, that's a good part. But listen, Paul, Ken.
One way.
Isn't it true
way to
that when
Lord.
You put men next to women, you have a man
be,
has a personality?
You're just talking about personalities.
Well, that's an important part of being a human
not,
being.
It's, it's
what do you have? There's only
the
two things, looks and personality.
Thing.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Broads are better looking jugs-wise and ass-wise and than guys are, but so what? Other than that, you know.
Well, women are not stupid. It's just that.
I never said they were stupid.
Right,
I said they're inferior to men.
And
they're
and
not stupid. They just have useless, shitty personalities. They're not
personality
idiots.
Is
I never
not
said they're
everything.
Idiots. I said men are superior. Because
and personality only? Then that's not superior.
What are you talking about? Are you trying to tell me that there's not good looking men? There's good looking men, right?
Right.
There's good looking women, right? There's tons of guys with good personalities, and there's like a smidgen of broads with good personalities. Therefore, men win in general. They're much better in general. There's only a few good twats
hey,
out
hey, Greg.
There. You know that.
Hey, Greg.
Come on! We called them many times.
Hey, Greg.
Remember that movie, A Few Good Twats with... You can't tell the truth! You can't tell the truth, Paula! Come on! You need me on that wall! You need me on that wall! Who's going to fight the battles for in Cuba against the fucking people that, you know, we're defending against Cuba? Is it going to be women? Is it going to be the twats?
No, because
no, you can't
we
tell
said...
the truth. You need men! On that wall!
We
us
send,
on that wall!
We send
you can't handle the truth, Paula!
We send
a few good twats! Remember that movie with Nicholson and Cruz?
Are you through?
You need
turn red, ain't he?
I
who
think...
built all the buildings in America? Men!
Because...
Where
yeah.
the cars come from? Men! Where did all
hey.
The houses come from? You think they just came out of nowhere? Men!
And who did they build them for?
No,
and,
I know
and,
broads, broads can give birth because God
no,
made it that way.
No, they built them
but
for the
so
women.
What?
They did
I
it
know,
for the women.
Who,
it's all for women.
All
so why does it
not
make
only,
it...
Not only are men better personality-wise, as you well know, but men are much more creative...
Oh, that's not true.
They are
that's
oh,
not true. That's
how
not
creative,
true.
How many great creative minds are there men and how many are women compared in comparison?
Well, you have
a
to
fraction.
Understand. You have to understand
so,
that
personality-wise, creativity-wise, I'm not saying smart.
It has something to
and,
do with
yes,
the
Ken,
with the opportunities a
you
lot
sound like
to
a
that
chauvinist.
As well.
I'm not a chauvinist. I'm just stating the facts.
No, some of his best friends are women.
You got better personalities. You've got more creative and all the stuff that civilization has. It's all for men.
Oh, that's bullshit. That's
oh, who invented the phone, the computer, cars? Who built the buildings? Who built the roads? Who built the... I mean, there's hardly any women involved in any of that.
Because
the subway system...
We were not allowed the opportunity
oh,
to do that.
Oh, now what are you doing? You're giving birth to
hey.
Babies. Come on.
Well, we're still doing that, yes. But we're also doing
did,
other things.
Did men make dildos, too? For other women?
I don't know if men made dildos. What kind of question is that? I do my few good twats, rant. Hold on a second. My few good, well, back to, a few good twats, rant, and you interrupt with that dildo question. Is that appropriate at this juncture? Okay. This week with Ken Vaughn, we had a good time, Ken. It was fun.
Oh, come
that's
on.
It?
No, you got to let us.
That's it.
What else do you have to say? It's not long enough for you?
I got something to talk about.
Well, we can't talk about that. So we're
why
gonna, not? We're not. We got to bring Jim Prey on for a second.
What? Who the hell's he?
He's a good
he's
guy.
A computer guy.
So you use that computer he uses. You're calling the computer guy like it's pejorative. Come on, he's okay. You don't like Jim Prey?
I didn't say it was.
Do
no.
you like him?
He's all right.
Yeah, he's cool. Sure. He's a male chauvinist pig. All right, let's bring Jim on for his thoughts about women. Ken and I agree that women are bad.
Not like smart women.
Okay. Is that true, Jim, that most men do not like smart women?
I don't know. Women are a total mystery to me, so I don't think I should be the one to ask.
No, but how about, I mean, would you prefer somebody smart, or do you prefer somebody who's just very attractive and who is easy to manipulate because they're stupid?
Who'd you rather fuck, a smart girl or a dumb broad?
I think I would like a smart woman. We could have good conversations with them. But if this woman is evil and conniving, and she's very smart, you're in bigger trouble.
Jim, you don't fuck smartness, do you? You know what I'm saying? Am I right, Paula?
Well, you know, you have to remember that that sexuality come. You know, your brains come into play as well, too. You know.
Is that true, Jim?
Of course.
Your brains come into play when you're having sex, and
that's what I've heard.
Okay. What about now? Oh, it's like the fantasy element, right?
Well, no,
like
not,
in
only,
your head,
not only that, but, you know...
You got to think things through.
Oh,
It's like dominoes.
What? Oh? What?
Anyways, Jim, so you think, your feeling, as you've already mentioned, I heard you say the words about women, if they're evil and conniving. You think that women are evil and conniving.
That's what a woman emailed me. She said, all women are evil and conniving.
And
but
you agree with that.
It's kind of a blanket statement. Don't you think all?
It's almost all.
I don't know. Women
right?
are
it's 99%.
Women are a mystery to me, and I really don't know. You should ask her because she's a woman. She's got a better chance of giving you the correct answer than me.
I'm just saying.
I don't think all women are evil.
Don't
I think
you agree?
Women have the same level of evilness as men.
Really?
Don't you agree with what I just said about a few good twats about how... Men created civilization. We built the buildings. We built the roads. We built the cars. We invented everything from the phone to the telegraph machine to the phonograph to radio.
They've repressed us because they
television.
Were afraid. They were afraid of what we could do.
Well,
so
women
they were repressed.
Who's kidding who? There's only a few freakish ones that can add, subtract, and do science.
We were repressed because you're afraid of us. You're afraid
Why would we be afraid of you?
Because we were in charge at one time.
But that was thousands of years ago.
Well, so what?
Well, I don't think anyone's been afraid since then.
Well, you were afraid enough to repress. Well, there have been female world leaders.
Well, I'm talking about USA.
The USA.
Go USA.
Oh, the USA, which is the only barometer of what women can do.
Let me say, Margaret Thatcher, she was good. Gold in my ear was good. And of course, Fanny Bryce was also.
I model myself after Fanny Bryce.
If you could, you would murder all women. Is that true?
No.
You would put them all on an island somewhere, right away from you. Is that true?
Just the total mystery to me. I would have scientists study them and try to figure them out.
So you would put them in like a little maze and drug them off and study them. That's what
no,
you would.
I didn't,
all
I didn't
women.
Say,
is that what you're saying? I understand. That's what you're saying. We got on tape.
I would say
study those broads.
I would say more research needs to be done on women.
The verdict's not in yet.
Because from somebody who have studied women and men said that men, only 5% of the men act correct towards women.
Okay, over to Jim McLaughlin, and he's live in Philadelphia. Jim, come in.
And Greg and Paula, this is a question for both of yous. This building that apparently is not being constructed presently, and the reason for that is A, construction workers are on strike, B, the crane at the very top stopped working, or C, they're waiting for the go-ahead from the Greg Sturley show so it can be their new international headquarters. Whatever your answer is, I'm sure it's correct. And good day.